Montebello Boxing Club, the home of Sergio Mora and other stars, standing near me, one of the best trainers in the business, Dean Campos, and I caught up with him today to talk about Edwin Valero.
So coach, tell me about Edwin Valero coming to the gym that you were at.
I was at another gym a few years back, and this guy comes in, he goes, oh, I want to join the gym, but he was talking in Spanish. So I gave him an application, he filled it out, he starts hitting the bag, I mean, unbelievable. He was just killing the gym. I mean, I could hear the gym like complaining. And then he left, like, oh yeah, he won't be back. It's like he's like all the other people. Came back the next day, same thing. The next day, same thing, hundreds of punches. I said, man, I gotta get this guy down. I got a little clicker. He started hitting the heavy bag for one round. And I was clicking, I was trying to go as quick as that. By the end of the round, like, my thumb was, it wouldn't even work anymore. He had thrown over 900 punches in 3 minutes. I couldn't believe it. And I was like, man, this guy's amazing. So a reporter friend of mine came by a few weeks later and goes, hey, you have anybody new here at the gym? I go, nah, you know, same old guys. And I go, hey, you know what, there is this one guy who comes here every now and then. I don't know who he is, but he's incredible. He came to the gym, I told him the whole story. And then he goes, what's his name? I go, let me go get his application. I went and got it, I think it's Edwin Valero? And he goes, Edwin Valero's here? I go, well, I don't know who he is. He goes, that guy's incredible, you gotta start training him. He told me the whole problem he had was his head and all this stuff in a motorcycle accident. But I couldn't believe this guy was, I had never seen anything like it. But I remember before I found out who he was, I even called Sergio up. I go, hey, sir, because Sergio lives in the next block. You gotta come and look at this guy train. I don't have no idea who he is. He might be some guy from the neighborhood or what, I don't know. Sergio came, we were watching, he was like, wow, dude, you gotta start working with this guy.
Why didn't you pull him over and say, what's your name, where you from? Well, you don't care about you, just this
he
boxing.
He was a quiet guy. I just thought he was like, no, everybody else. But people would stop and watch him when he was training. People would get tired just watching him.
Do you think he would beat Manny Pacquiao if they fought?
Oh, that's a tough one. You know, I mean, Valero didn't care too much about boxing or anything like that. So maybe defensively, that would be his problem. And the level of competition. But if he had a better level of competition, maybe a couple more years, maybe working some defensive moves, and then it would have been interesting. Because I know he would go down in a couple fights, but he would get up. And he would just outpoint everybody. He wanted to spar. Nobody wanted to spar with him. He got in the ring with one guy one time and hit him, threw a couple punches, and the guy quit after, like, getting hit with two or three punches. Because this guy hits too hard. And the other guy weighs about 170 pounds.
27-0, 27 knockouts. We all know the tragic ending. He killed his wife. He killed himself. Did that shock you when you heard that story?
Yes, then no. Because the way his demeanor was in the gym, he was possessed. He was like a demon when he came into the gym. He walked in, killed the gym, 2 hours to whatever he was in there. He never stopped moving.
Not even took, didn't take breaks? Did he take water breaks or
He would stop and get a little bit of water, but he never, somebody was in the way, he walked right through. It was like he was by himself. So everybody just got out of his way. He just got out of his way. Here comes that guy, get out of the way. Get out of his way. And I would tell everybody, see that guy right there? Do something like him every day. Then maybe you could become something. And I had no idea who he was. He was amazing.
They say that his trainer told me that he did 30 rounds a minute, that he trained 5 hours at a time. You seeing him in person, how far would he have gone in the history of boxing?
Like I said, if he learned a little bit of defense, he probably would have been, man, can't even, I don't know, man. I mean, you never know. I can't predict it, but I know that he would have been a lot of great fighters. He would have been right up there with everybody. And maybe it would have taken a loss for him to come back and maybe think about defense, like Barrera did.
What year was that with the gym that you saw?
I'd say like 2005, somewhere around there. Between 2005, 2006, somewhere around there.
He was still doing very well with his career. He must have been like 22-0, 20-0, 20 knockouts.
I think it was like 19-0. I didn't know anything until the reporter told me.
And he had 21 of his knockouts in the first round. That's a Guinness Book of Records record right there. 21 first. What do you think about first round knockouts, by the way?
Well,
Bruce Trampler is quoted. Richard Schaefer told me, quoted him, that first round knockouts don't count.
You know what? Sometimes, well, most of the time, I'll be honest with you. If somebody offered my guy a fight and told me, do you want to fight a guy that has 2 first round knockouts or the guy that has 2 wins by decision and won all the rounds? I'll take the guy that won by first round knockout. I would put my guy against him. Because we know he can win in one round, but can he? What happens in the second and third and fourth?
You might run out
we already
of gas.
Know the other guy can box for 4 rounds or 5, 6 rounds. I would go with that.
Look at him. After 1 round, he's already about to faint there.
That he ain't Edwin Valero.
Yeah.
He's richer, but you know.
Hey, you guys show me you do the myth, bro.
Yeah, no.
Come on. We got
all
you.
Right, go ahead. I'm gonna show him when he comes in.
Okay. Let's see what you got, Richard. What you were saying?
Yeah, but like I said, he ain't no Edwin Valero. But the type of person that Edwin Valero was is probably better off not that he killed his wife, but he probably, I heard he was done a couple of accidents in his car.
Yeah, he had a few
drunk, and he might have killed somebody else, you know what I mean? Unfortunately, he killed his own wife, but that's a sad story. But he was just, I don't know too much about him, but the little stories I did read, and like when he was at the gym, he behaved, you know what I mean? I know the bags didn't like him too much, but not too many people come down the pike like him. Very rare talent. But like I said, sometimes your own talent can be your own worst nightmare. Your anger.
Your demon.
Yeah, like, you know, there's certain fighters that you could guarantee they were going to be something great. Like Marshall Martinez back in the day. 2000, you went to the 2000 Olympian team and then he dropped off. That was amazing. You know, to me, he was going to be the next Roberto Duran. But the things that made him great inside the ring made him he wasn't a bad guy, but he found himself in the wrong positions all the time. And he was a real good kid, and just couldn't stay keep himself straight. And now he's in prison or something like that. I know he's in prison now, and he could have been something great. And that's what you don't want. Sometimes you don't want that person to be so great that they can't stop themselves when they come out of the ring. There's got to be an even, something that makes them. Maybe they have something they can't do in the ring, but also it makes them be civilized outside the ring.
Sugar Ray Leonard.
Yeah,
perfect
exactly.
Balance.
Yep, exactly.
Even Pacquiao, love him or hate him, at least out of the ring he's balanced.
Yeah, he's not so ferocious that he takes it outside the ring. He's just cracking guys and something, outside the ring.
That's your Manny Pacquiao, your gym right there.
Yep. There you have it from the Montebello Boxing Club, 1301 West Olympic Boulevard. Come here and check it out. FaceNewsReporting.com. Now let's take back reporting.